Hi all, today we can discuss about the complex form of Fourier series. The general formula what we have studied earlier for as the Fourier series, it consisting of the Fourier coefficients a0, an and bn. Sometimes it is easy to solve these Fourier series in terms of the complex form. So let's see what is the complex form of Fourier series. The general formula is f of x is equal to sigma n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity cn e raised to inx, where cn is equal to 1 by 2 pi minus pi 2 pi f of x e raised to minus inx ds. If you are writing this complex form in terms of the period 2l, then we can write it as cn e raised to I n pi x by l. Here that also becomes my integral minus l to l f of x e raised to minus I n pi x by l. Okay, so we can see how this equation came. So proof is, the general formula for the Fourier series is f of x is equal to a0 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity an cos nx plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity bn sin nx. So what we are doing here is, just we are applying this complex form of cos nx and sin nx here. That is, f of x is equal to a0 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity. What is cos nx? An into cos nx is e raised to inx plus e raised to minus inx divided by 2 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity bn, the sin nx in terms of complex, that is e raised to inx minus e raised to minus inx divided by 2i. Okay, now we can just combine the coefficients of e raised to inx together and e raised to minus inx together. So what we are getting is a0 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity. Here what is e raised to inx coefficient? Here it is an, here it is bn by 2i. So whenever this I term is in the denominator, we can change that as by multiplying both numerator and denominator with I. So this is I square is minus 1. So this becomes minus ibn by 2. So here e raised to inx coefficient is minus ibn by 2 plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity, the coefficient of e raised to minus inx. What is e raised to minus inx coefficient here? Here it is an, there it is minus ibn by 2 into minus 1, that is plus ibn by 2. Okay, so now we can change these terms into a simpler way, that is a0, I am writing it as c0 plus cn e raised to sigma n equal to 1 to infinity e raised to n e raised to inx plus sigma n equal to 1 to infinity c minus n e raised to minus inx. Here it is e raised to minus inx, here it is e raised to plus inx. So what is here c n c minus n c0? That is, whatever we are using is where C0 is same as A0. C0 is same as A0. And Cn is equal to, what is Cn here? It is clear that it is An minus Ibn by 2. An minus Ibn by 2. And C minus n is An plus Ibn by 2. So these three terms together we can write it as sigma n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity cn e raised to inx. F of x is equal to sigma n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to cn e raised to inx. This is the complex form of the Fourier series. Now how it comes? Because the when n equal to 0, where n equal to 0 leads to which term? When n equal to 0, this become c0 e raised to 0. E raised to 0 is 1. That is, it is same as this c0. Okay. So, here from n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity. That is, if n is equal to minus infinity to n is equal to minus 1 will lead this as c, this is c minus n term. That is, this is c minus n e raised to minus inx. That we corresponding to this, that is, this n equal to minus infinity to minus infinity minus 1 will leads to the term c minus n, and what about n equal to plus 1 to plus infinity will leads to the term c plus n, that is corresponding to an minus ibn by 2. Okay, now we can find out what is this c plus n term, that is whatever we had written here, cn is equal to 1 by 2 pi minus pi 2 by f of x e raised to minus INS, yes. So how can we find out this CN? What is the CN? Whatever we are getting from here is AN minus IBN by 2. Okay. AN minus IBN divided by 2. So we can substitute the term what we studied for the Fourier coefficient AN and BN. So what is the Fourier coefficient AN? AN is equal to 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x cos nx dx. This is we have studied in the first Fourier series video. This coefficient, Fourier coefficient, is 1 by pi minus pi to pi f of x cos nx dx minus I into bn coefficient is 1 by pi integral minus pi to pi f of x sin nx dx. Sin nx dx. Okay, here there is 1, 2 term is also here. So we can write that 1 by 2 as common. So what we are getting is just combine this. That is here pi is common, pi is common. So we can take it outside. 1 by 2 pi. And here we are getting here minus pi 2 pi f of x. We can combine these both these integral. So minus pi 2 pi f of x. What is getting here? Cos nx minus what is here? I sin nx dx. Okay, it is nothing but 1 by 2 pi minus pi 2 pi f of x, what is this cos nx minus I sin nx, that is e raised to minus I nx dx. Okay, so what we are getting now is the formula for the CN coefficient. That is, what is CN coefficient? CN is equal to 1 by 2 pi minus pi 2 pi f of x e raised to minus inx dx. Okay. So, similarly, we can find the coefficient C minus n. So, V minus n is an plus ibn by 2. Only difference is here we will get cos nx plus I sin nx. Then this formula becomes e raised to inx. If it is n equal to 0, then C 0. Then we will get n equal to 0. This become minus pi 2 pi f of x e raised to 0, that is 1, that is f of x dx only. So in general, whether it is n is equal to 0 or minus n or plus n, the general formula we can write like this, n is equal to 1 by 2 pi minus pi f by 2 pi f of x e raised to minus inx dx. So that the that's about the coefficient CN. Okay, so using this we can see some problems, then the it become more clear. Okay. Find the complex form of f of x is equal to e raised to ax in the interval minus pi to pi. So how can we find this using this formula? So f of x is equal to general formula sigma n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity cn e raised to inx. So first our task is to find out this coefficient cn. What is cn? Cn is equal to 1 by 2 pi minus pi 2 pi f of x e raised to minus inx ds. Since already the interval is given in terms of pi, we can directly use. If it is in terms of L, what we have to write? Minus L2 plus L f of x e raised to minus in pi x by L. Okay. So we can find out the coefficient now. Cn is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi 2 pi f of x. What is our f of x here? E raised to ax. So this become e raised to ax into e raised to minus inx dx. E raised to minus inx dx. So on combining this, we are getting 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi 2 pi e raised to a minus in into x dx. Okay. So we can integrate this. That is 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi 2 pi e raised to x integral is same as e raised to x. So e raised to a minus in x divided by a minus in. Okay. Okay. This is we have to apply here the limit 0 to pi, sorry, minus pi to pi. Okay, minus pi to pi. So we can apply the upper limit first. So 1 by 2 pi, the a minus in I am taking outside. So on applying, this become e raised to a minus in into pi minus lower limit, that is e raised to a minus in into minus pi. Okay, Now we can split this, that is e raised to a pi into e raised to minus I n pi minus e raised to minus a pi into e raised to this minus I n into minus pi is plus I n pi. Okay, here it is 1 by 2 pi a minus I n. Okay, now this become 1 by 2 pi a minus I n into what is e raised to minus I n pi? E raised to minus I n pi is equal to cos n pi minus I sin n pi. Okay, that is I sin n pi is always sin n pi is 0. So this term will cancel and this become cos n pi. The cos n pi is equal to minus 1 raised to n. If you are taking e raised to I n pi, then what will becomes? Then it becomes cos n pi plus I sin n pi. Then also it becomes minus 1 raised to n. So whether it is e raised to minus I n pi or e raised to plus I n pi, answer is minus 1 raised to n. So here it becomes minus 1 raised to n into e raised to a pi. So I am taking this minus 1 raised to n outside, because here it is minus 1 raised to n, here also minus 1 raised to n. So minus 1 raised to n into e raised to a pi minus e raised to minus a pi. So this become 1 by, see this e raised to a pi minus e raised to minus a pi, there 2 is here. Okay, I am writing this 2 here. So what we are getting, this is the form of which function? Hyperbolic sine function. A raised to a pi minus e raised to minus I pi. A pi. If the I term is, iota term is not in the numerator, that means that is related with the hyperbolic function. If it is minus, what is this function? This is sine h a pi. So what we have outside is minus 1 raised to n pi into a minus I n. This is our Cn coefficient. What we have to write? We have to write the complex form of the function e raised to x. So complex form is f of x is equal to sigma n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity Cn e raised to I n x. So what we are now getting, that is equal to sigma n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity. Infinity. What is our Cn here? Sin h a pi. Okay. So the, what sin h a pi divided by pi, and here it is minus 1 raised to n divided by a minus I n. Okay. So if we want, we can take the complex conjugate of this function too. That is a minus I n is taking complex conjugate, multiply both numerator and denominator with a plus I n. Then we can write it as sin h a by pi minus 1 raised to n into a plus I n divided by a square plus n square. If in multiple choice questions they are asking such an options. Okay. So we can take this sin h a pi by pi. It is not having any n term, sin h a pi. So I am taking outside. So sin h a by pi by pi into n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity minus 1 raised to n divided by a minus I n. Okay, so this is the complex form of the given function. So one advantage also finding this complex form is that there is no need to find this a0, a n, b n separately. We are getting a direct one. So maybe in exams they will ask find the complex form, and we have to follow this method. Okay, now we can see one more question. Okay, see this question. The coefficient of e raised to I kx in the Fourier expansion of ux equal to ca sin square alpha x for k equal to minus 2 alpha is. Four options are given. This question was asked in GATE physics examination in 2017. So let's see how to do this question. So from this question is clear that what form we have to use as for the Fourier expansion. They are asked the coefficient of e raised to I kx. So we have to find out the complex form of the given function. So that we can find out using this given equation, that is f of x is equal to sigma n equal to minus infinity to plus infinity cn e raised to I n x. Here they are asking the coefficient of e raised to I k x. Therefore, just we can replace this n by the k term. That is sigma k equal to minus infinity to plus infinity ck e raised to I k x. Okay. So what will be our ck there? Ck is the coefficient, that is 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi to pi. This is f of x. So f of x, what is our f of x here? a sin square alpha x. Okay, that is we can find out f of x e raised to minus I, and we have replaced by k. So now we can find out this integral. Therefore, ck is equal to 1 by 2 pi integral minus pi to pi f of x. F of x is a sin square alpha s. To make it in the complex form, we can write it as f of x is equal to a sin square alpha s in the form of e exponential terms. That is, it is equal to a into sin square is sin alpha x is e raised to I alpha x minus e raised to minus I alpha x divided by 2i sin square. So we have to apply the square 2. So what we are getting here, this 2 square is 4, I square is minus 1. So we are getting here minus a by 4 outside, and in the within the bracket it becomes e raised to I 2 alpha x minus e raised to minus I 2 alpha x. This is plus term. Okay, plus minus a square plus b square minus 2ab. So minus 2ab is 2 into e raised to my I alpha x into e raised to minus I alpha x. So when we are adding the exponents, that is I alpha x plus minus I alpha, that becomes e raised to 0, and e raised to 0 is 1. Okay, so we can take this term to here, that is minus a by 4 f of x. Okay, f of x is minus a by 4 into e raised to I 2 alpha x. In the question already he given one more option, k is equal to minus 2 alpha. So this in, on this position 2 alpha we can substitute as minus k. So this become e raised to 2 alpha is minus k, that is minus I k x plus e raised to I into minus 2 alpha. What is minus 2 alpha? K. I k x minus 2. Okay. So this is about this f of x. This is about this f of s, and into what is the e raised to minus I k x dx. Okay. So on integrating this, we are getting minus 1 by 2 pi. Here it is minus a, we can take here, into 4 minus pi 2 pi. Okay, minus pi to pi, this e raised to minus I kx into e raised to minus I kx is e raised to minus 2 I kx plus e raised to I kx into e raised to minus I kx is 1 minus, because we become e raised to I kx minus e raised to minus I kx become e raised to 0, that is equal to 1 minus 2 e raised to minus I kx dx. Okay, now we can integrate this, that is minus a divided by 8 pi minus pi 2 pi. On integrating this, we are getting e raised to minus 2 I k x divided by minus 2 I k plus 1 integral is x minus 2 e raised to minus I k x divided by minus I k. Apply the limit minus pi 2 plus pi. So this is minus a by 8 pi. What is this integral? This one, applying this, this become 2 minus 2 I k pi. Okay. Minus, on applying the lower limit, it become e raised to minus 2 I k pi minus e raised to, on applying the lower limit, it become 2 I k pi. Okay. So we already seen that e raised to minus I n pi or e raised to plus I n pi is minus 1 raised to n. So here also this become minus 1 raised to n. N means here it is 2 k. Okay, minus 1 raised to 2k. Here it is minus minus 1 raised to 2k. This same term will come and it become 0. So this integral completely become 0. Then what about this integral? Here also it is e raised to minus I k pi minus e raised to the same form here. That is e raised to minus I k pi minus e raised to plus I k pi. Then also this becomes e raised to minus 1 raised to k minus 1 raised to k. This term also becomes 0. So the remaining term is only x. So on applying the x, the upper limit is pi minus, on lower limit minus pi. So what we are getting is 2 pi. Okay, so that is minus a divided by 8 pi into 2 pi. So this pi pi will cancel. And what we are getting as the ck is minus a divided by -a/4. So we got the coefficient ck is equal to -a/4. So on applying, what the question, our the coefficient of e raised to x in the Fourier expansion. So this is our Fourier expansion. So on this Fourier expansion, at the place of the CK, what we are getting? That is CK is minus A by 4 into sigma K equal to minus infinity to plus infinity e raised to IKS. So the coefficient of e raised to IKX is minus A by 4. So the answer is option B. Okay. So you try more questions. It is easy than the general formula methods, because only we have to use these exponential forms, and the integration also very easy. Okay. So try more questions. All the best. Bye bye.